little box here. Kind of odd how to. I'm debating on how to open it. Maybe you can cut this plastic, this paper. Oh yeah, it's not solid. I was looking at it like it was a solid thing, and I was like, how does this thing open up? We have the world famous eBay tissue paper. Now there should be two, I assume there's two trucks in here. Yes, there is. One of them just flopped out of here. And the other one just flopped out of here. Alright, so these are obviously some just little Hot Wheel Chevy trucks here. Let me get this accurate here. This is a 1996 Chevy 1500. Now these are kind of odd Hot Wheels. They have metal chassis and plastic bodies, which nowadays is not totally unusual, but back in the day they were not typically plastic bodied. So kind of an odd thing. I do have one of these, which I actually found at my uncle found at the junkyard when he was searching through stuff. And I'll have to get mine. I think this one and the one from that came from the junkyard, I think they look about the same condition wise. But before I go get it, we'll check this one out. You can see it's got the, I don't know what the name of this grill is, but there's a couple different grills that these trucks had. There was there was this grill here with the bar that went across it, and then there was a grill that had a completely different headlights in it. Light setup was completely different. Now these are set up as like racing trucks. You got your shifter and your fire extinguisher next to your seat. Looks like it's got a three-point harness and it's got a roll cage in it. So kind of a more set up for racing. Obviously this one is. This one could be either way, but it is also a race truck. As you can see, they both have the tonneau covers on the back with the wing. You could do some customs with these if you wanted to, and probably make them look more like a civilian model if you so desired. Now they don't make this casting anymore, so had to get on eBay and find two of them. I needed two of them and couldn't find them. So this one's actually in really good shape. And I haven't seen this one before. Let's see. Power Charger Racing. We have a figure eight, or maybe just an eight, and a bunch of arrows and a black circle. It kind of looks like the power booster that Hot Wheels has for their tracks. You know, it's got the wheels that spin around on it, and the cars go through the middle and it shoots them out. I don't think those were called power chargers, though. I think they were power boosters. But I don't know, that could be what this is supposed to be, as a power charger. This could have came with like a racetrack set. You know, you buy a Hot Wheels set and it came with this truck. That's a very high possibility, actually. It's got the kind of racy style wheels. American Racing wheels. I think American Racing made some wheels that look like that. Now you can't actually feel the cast line in the plastic in the mold, but it's there on both of these trucks. It's very visible. I showed you the inside of this one already. There you can see the grille a little better. This one has a painted base. I thought this had a silver base on it, but it looks like it's unpainted. So I'll go get my other one that looks like that and we'll compare the two. So this one here, I painted the headlights in on it, but this one does have a painted base. Now I don't know, maybe there's a couple variations because it doesn't look like there's any silver paint anywhere on this one. Maybe there was once. Just sure doesn't look like it. But anyway. Well, the base is better on this, the junkyard truck, and the graphics are better on the truck I just got. But not a whole lot better. That's interesting. They're about the same condition. Yeah, you can see the mold line in this one too. And the other grill that I was talking about, this is a Johnny Lightning, I think, yeah. But this is the other grill I was talking about. You know, it's got the singular headlight, and then it's got a turn signal over here and a turn signal underneath the headlight. You can use the one that I painted in the lights. You can see the difference here. Looks like I missed my light a little bit there. Sometimes that comes right off. It's not wanting to right now, but I get it off. But anyway, you can see the difference in the grills. So, nothing super special, just something I thought I'd show you that I got. Been kind of looking for this model, and I found two of them for pretty cheap, so I thought I'll just buy two of them. So we have one more mystery thing in here, and since I'm excited about those two trucks there, I can't really remember what's in here. Obviously the whole thing is right here, so we'll just cut that and open it up. Whatever it is, it's wrapped up nicely, and it's in a Ziploc bag. Oh yes, ShoeBox from the Hot Wheels Classics series that they sadly don't produce anymore. Actually, I don't know if they make ShoeBox anymore. Wow, I forgot what a beautiful car ShoeBox is in this. It's not Spectraflame paint, but it's a lot like Spectraflame. It may be Spectraflame. Now, I have this exact model from when I was a little kid, but it's got some issues with it, so I wanted to get a really nice one because of how pretty this car is. I don't care for the chrome interior. It should have been like white or something. You can see it does read Classics on the side there. And on the hood, that was the name of the series this car was in. It was Hot Wheels Classics. And, of course, it's an old Ford. Hot Wheels just called this ShoeBox, as you can see there. Now, this one's all metal. It's got the metal base and the metal body. The grill is actually plastic connected to the, probably the motor, and the interior is all one piece, I'd assume. The white walls look good on it, too. So, really nice looking car here. So, like I said in the previous video, just some different Hot Wheels here. I will go ahead and put these on the turntable for you. And I think that's going to be the end of our video. So like, comment, subscribe for more. Have a great day. I'll catch you in the next video. And yeah, if you're looking for these trucks, good luck. I had some troubles finding them on eBay. Those were the only two I could find that were not ridiculously priced. And then I buy a lot of like boxes, you know, at garage sales. I'll just, you know, what do you take for the whole box or whatever? And I'm yet to get very many of these. Before I bought these two, this one here was the only one I had, so maybe they didn't make a whole lot of these. So have a great day.